that's it. That's Twisted Metal. I'll do a little review just to close it up. I really like the game. It's fun. Like, when I first started playing it, I never played a Twisted Metal game before. So this is my first Twisted Metal game. And I don't know how to... I can't say anything about how it compares to the other Twisted Metal games, but as a game on its own, I think it's great. I think the graphics still hold up today. And the music's fantastic. You know, it's very fitting. A lot of it's real music. But it's real music that fits. The game really oozes a lot of style, I think. That's really the draw to the game. You know, like, if you boil it down, it's just like a bunch of cars with guns on them blowing each other up. And that by itself is dull, but, like, the way the cars look and the way the characters look, you know, Sweet Tooth, he's very iconic. He, like, even before I ever played Twisted Metal, like, I knew about Sweet Tooth. Like, he's like, the iconic character from Twisted Metal. But even the other characters, they all look really cool and interesting. And that leads into, like, the story, which I think was told very well. Like, I don't completely understand exactly what's going on, but the way it's told in, like, kind of a cool way that is compelling. And, you know, it doesn't have to be all that... Oh, wait, there's
on
more.
That night, he did cut me.
There's more story. Hold on.
But he didn't kill me.
What's going on?
If he wanted me dead... he would have done it. He had to have known. He was too good to miss something like that.
Say cheese. Cheese.
He had to know. I survived. He kept me alive so I could continue his good work. So I could carry on his legacy. He kept me alive in case something happened to him. Father was my hero. And Calypso killed him.
Yeah, pretty intense.
Soon, I'll be strong enough to return the favor.
This is Dracula. So, like I was saying, What was I saying? Oh yeah, I was talking about the story. Now I'm worried that I might get copyrighted because he's playing Dracula in the background. anyway, but I'll just do it. And whatever happens, happens. Speaking of the story, yeah, it's told in a very compelling way, a very interesting way, I think. And the most important thing is that it's non-intrusive, you know, it doesn't try to shove it down your throat. You get an intro and then you get an outro. And it's using live action instead of CGI for everything, but it doesn't come off as corny. You know, if you see some, like, live action video game cutscenes from the late 90s and, like, PS1 and stuff, Resident Evil comes to mind, that's corny as hell and it's badly done. But in this, it's done well. You know, the actors, they kind of nailed their characters. So that's great, and it all adds to the atmosphere and the universe of Twisted Metal, which is the real big appeal to this game. The gameplay-wise, like, when I first started playing it, I was just kind of like, is this all it is, just shooting cars and shit like that? But, you know, even though, yeah, that kind of is all it is, it does vary up the gameplay. With a couple of different styles. You have the cage matches, you have the races, and then you have destroying the juggernaut things, and then you have the boss fights. And, you know, they do repeat those for each chapter, but, you know, they vary it up a bit so that it's still new and it's still more... It gets progressively more challenging and it's still fun. And I like that. I like the first race. The second race was a little chaotic. The third race, though, that was dog shit. Like, you don't know where to go. And you have to basically rely on looking where everyone else is going. That is terrible. That third race is probably my least favorite part of the game. The only other thing I would say is that it can get a little repetitive. I'm pretty sure this is primarily a multiplayer game, but they still did a good job with the single player. I'm glad they didn't skimp on the single player. I'm sure most people would just play this for the multiplayer alone, because it really is just like Deathmatch, but it's done well and it's fun. Graphics-wise, I think it holds up. This game came out in, I think, 2012, so it still looks pretty good. And I'm playing in standard definition, and it still looks good, so yeah, I don't have any real complaints there. It's a good game. I recommend anyone who's interested in car combat games to try it out, but anyone who's into car combat games, I'm sure they already have tried it. But like I said, I don't know how it compares to the other Twisted Metal games. It's really its own genre, and it's kind of a genre that's slowly dying out. But I'm glad they made this game. One of the last games in the genre. It's a good game, I liked it. And that's all I really have to say about it. So, what'd you guys think?